Hello, hello friends. Welcome back to our channel, You Next Officer. We are back with our initiative of discussion of sociology mains question and will provide you a model answer for same. So do subscribe, share and like our channel guys, and for model answer join our Telegram channel. So today is the 8th day. So let's begin with the question. Write a short note on sociology and anthropology. Here in this question, we'll discuss about what is sociology and how sociology is interlinked with the subject like anthropology. So we are here in the unit 1, and in this unit 1, through the discussion of different questions, we are done with the unit 1 today, and from tomorrow onwards we'll start with the unit 2, right? So here is the question, that is, we have to find out what is in this question. We need to understand how to approach the question. See, my task is, my objective is to not only make you write the question, not only provide you model answer, but make you understand how to how to write the question. So here it is. Sociology and anthropology. Sociology and anthropology. So first we need to understand, according to the question, sociology is a present complex society. See, we need to introduce our question, whether it is an introduction, whether it is a body part, or whether it is a conclusion part. We need to write according to the demand of the question, right? It is very important to understand the demand of the question. If you understand the demand of the question and write accordingly, definitely you'll able to fetch good marks, right? So here the demand is, we don't need to write the definition of sociology, the emergence of sociology in the European history, trace back to the European history. There's no need to write such definition in this question, right? So what it is, what we have to write, see, what this question is saying, sociology is the study of present complex society, okay? So we need to compare it in this question. We need to compare it, one, and whether we need to establish a correlation with it, with this two subject, right? So sociology is the study of a present complex society, social institutions and social actions. Whereas anthropology is a study of simple, primitive society, right? An interaction with each other and led to the development of the society. So first is the definition part, what we do in the sociology and what we do in the anthropology. So in the sociology, we study the present society, whereas in the anthropology, we study the primitive society, right? This is the first point. We study the present society plus social institution, whatever it is present. Right, in this anthropology, we study the primitive society, their interaction, their society, how society developed, right? Moving on to, this is our first introduction part, right, in a one para, and we compare it. Moving on to the second part, means second paragraph, right? Okay, sociologist uses, so other would be, the first one would be the definition or the comparison, what we study, right? In the very first paragraph, we get to know about it. In the second paragraph, we need to understand the sociologist, how sociologists study the society and how anthropologists study the society. We need to differentiate it, right? Plus, interlinking of these two subjects is also important, that we'll see in the further paragraphs. Okay, so sociologist uses Sociologist uses the social survey. Survey, that is sociologist uses an anthropologist, right? Sociologist uses survey, case study, questionnaire to know about the society, right? To know about the society, right? Whereas anthropologists, what they do, they use ethnomethodology to study the society. Ethnomethodology to study the society, right? So this is one part. Moving on to next part. This is the next paragraph. As a discipline of sociology developed and requires the study of present society in the context of the old and primitive, one is established with the cause and effect of a present society. See, if we want to study the society, as we already done in the sociology and the comparison of an interlinkage of sociology and history, if we want to study the sociology as a subject, right, we need to understand to study the present society. Then we'll able to predict any method, right? And if we understand, see how it is very easy if we understand the primitive society, how our Rigvedic people live, how our Rigvedic or Harappans people live, we'll get to know how they work, right? One thing is very known to the Harappan, whether their drainage system, right? So we can learn their skills. We can learn from their skills, right? So it is important that the sociology is required to be linked with the anthropology. So in this third paragraph, see, everything is written and everything is given in our model answer, right? My objective is not to only, I already told you, my objective is not only to provide you model answer, but through the discussion, we'll able to get how to write the answer, right? Moving on to next part. We have to write the example. So in the example, the Iravati Karve studied the Mahabharat from the feminist perspective. See, when we talk about the Mahabharat, it is a primitive society, studying of a primitive society, right? And studying the primitive society through the sociological perspective, that is sociological perspective, we get to know about the society, right? We get to know about the society, people, right? How they react. Do you get my point, all of you? Yes. So, we write to give the example, that is Iravati Karve studied the Mahabharat through the feminist perspective using socio-anthropological lens, right? What lens Iravati Karve applied? Iravati is a socio-anthropological lens, means perspective. Lens here is with, what does it mean by perspective, right? The position of the women in the past, present was linkage, right? Next, present patriarchy. See, if we get to know about the Mahabharat, right? Mahabharat, will also get to know about the patriarchy, right? How Draupadi was treated in that, and that is it. The way the whole Mahabharat and the scripture treated women is a reflection and a manifestation of what? Is a reflection and manifestation of patriarchy, right? To get my point. So this is the way how sociology and the anthropology is linked. Now moving on to the next part, that is the conclusion part. When we talk about the conclusion part, conclusion is sociology. See, this is a 10 marker question and we have to write 2 pages only. Means 2 sides of the pages, right? So no need to write the story. We need to only write which is relevant for our examination, right? So sociology and anthropology is a systematic and scientific study, scientific way of studying the society in a coordinated, collaborative manner, and which help in clearing the picture of society institution. See, at the end, the conclusion should be happy conclusion, right? It establishes a better linkage between sociology and anthropology. How? As it is a systematic study, right? It is a scientific as well, right? It is a correlative, right? To give this picture of what? To study about the society, whether it is a present society or primitive society. See, if we get to know about the present primitive society, as we have seen in the Mahabharat, right, we get to know about the present society, how patriarchy is entrenched in our society. We get to know about the patriarchy and the manifestation and the extent of the patriarchy in the mind and the culture of the people. We'll get to know about it, right? So the establishing a link between anthropology and sociology in the conclusion is very important, right? Here it is given in our model answer. Everything is given in the model answer. That is the introduction part, what you have to write next. After that, the body part, this next page, and finally conclusion. So one thing that you can add in this answer, which is missing in this answer, is thinkers, right? I generally not preferred writing or flooding your answer with the thinkers only, rather than writing in your own words, right? But you have to write. What should be the approach? See, many of you asked me, and many of the other students also asked me how to approach the question. If we don't write thinkers, how to? So what should be our approach, right? What I'm suggesting to all, and what I am following for myself as well, is write your own sentence. Write your own answer, right? And substantiate it with the thinker. For example, if you're writing about the farmer suicide, right? Write your own perspective. And in the context of the, in order to substantiate your answer, you can use Emile Durkheim. Right, you get to know about me, get to know about that point. Yes, so guys, that's it for today. Today is a end of our unit 1. From tomorrow onwards, one topic is left. I think it has not been asked yet, the scope of sociology, as I have already discussed the difference between the different difference or the comparison or similarity, sociology and other subject matter. But yet I think, according to me, everything is covered. Now what we need to do, from the tomorrow onwards, we'll cover the unit 2. That is, this is a small unit, and then the unit 3, and finally the unit 4, which definitely gives you a better insight about the thinkers, right? So that's it for today. Do subscribe, like, and share our channel, and give your suggestion so that I'll able to incorporate your suggestion. I'll try to incorporate your suggestions, and let me know, guys, what you want, how to improve the content and to reach more people. And one more thing, guys, for the model answer, join our Telegram channel. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.